am Mary Grace de Mendoza, the reporter today in Educational Philosophy. My task is to report the articulating a K-12 program philosophy. If we say articulate, it means expressing oneself readily, clearly, and effectively. The philosophy of education is the study of the purpose, process, nature, and ideals of education. This can be within the context of education as a societal institution or more broadly as the process of human existential growth. Example, how is it that our understanding of the world is continually transformed, be it from facts, social customs, experiences, or even our own emotions? At present, the Philippines is the only country in Asia and among the three remaining countries in the world that uses a 10-year basic education cycle. According to a presentation made by the Southeast Asian Ministers of Education Organization or SEMEO Indotec on additional years in Philippine basic education year 2010. The comparative data on duration of basic and pre-university education in Asia shows that the Philippines allots 10 years not just for the basic education cycle, but also for the pre-university of education, while all the other countries have either 11 or 12 years in their basic education cycle. Curriculum is described as congested. This means that students do not get enough time to perform tasks because the curriculum is designed to be taught in a span of 12 years and not 10 years. The more obvious result of this is the fact that most high school students graduate without the readiness to take upon higher education or employment. These students are not equipped with the basic skills or competences needed at work. President Benigno Simeon Aquino III signed into law on May 15, 2013, the Enhanced Basic Education Act of 2013, or the K-12. Now that it has become a law, schools all over the country have to brace for the implementation and the effects of the K-12 program. The K-12 is aimed at addressing the deficiency of the Philippine educational system, particularly in the basic education, the elementary and high school, in order to meet the standards of the international education criteria and for the students to be at par with the students in neighboring countries. According to DepEd discussion paper year 2010, the K-12 curriculum aims to enable every child to achieve mastery of core competences and skills, and develop tracks based on the student's interests and competencies. What are the core competencies and skills needed by any individual across cultures? The three R's: reading, writing, and arithmetic. When these core competencies learned, research has shown that the three R's should commence at the age of 3 or 4, some even earlier. Philosopher Froebel, known as the father of kindergarten, established the first kindergarten in Germany in 1837. Influenced by Rousseau, Pestalozzi, and Herbart, for Bail believed children were social creatures, and learning was the most natural and efficient through activity, and play was an essential part of learning. He believed that teaching methods between a younger and older child ought to be vastly different. As we all know, that the K-12 program will provide a holistic education for all students. This means that the students will improve communication and social skills, increase positive peer interaction, and many educational outcomes. Moreover, students will gain more knowledge and experience that will be essential in the future. These fundamental questions guide the overarching philosophy of the program. 1. Why learn specific discipline? Next question. Upon what guiding principles is our program built? What are our core beliefs about teaching and learning in specific discipline? Next, what are the essential questions? Or how will we use assessment to improve the program and student learning? As such, the program philosophy provides a unifying framework that justifies and gives direction to discipline-based instruction.
Philosophy guiding the K-12 program.
After having studied curriculum trends and assessed the current program, curriculum developers should be ready to construct a draft philosophy guiding the K-12 program. Such a philosophy or set of beliefs should be more than just what we think should be happening, but rather what our curriculum is actually striving to reflect. The Enhanced Basic Education Act of 2013, or Republic Act 10533, did not only lengthen the number of years of basic education, but also provided that basic education may not only be delivered via regular schools, but may likewise be delivered through the alternative learning system. Acceleration of students or learners in public and private basic educational institution is still allowed in accordance with the Department of Education rules and regulations. The very goal of the K-12 program is to produce 21st century graduates equipped with the core values and lifelong competencies they need to contribute to societal development and nation building. The K-12 program in the Philippines was introduced in 2013. It was in 2013 when Republic Act 10533 became a law. This law is known as the Enhanced Basic Education Act of 2013. It was popularly called K-12 because of the Act. Republic Act 10533 enhanced the Philippine basic education system by strengthening its curriculum and increasing the number of years for basic education. Basic education in the Philippines before K-12 consists of 6 years of elementary education and 4 years of high school education. The Enhanced Basic Education Act of 2013, or K-12 as it is commonly known now, provides for a mandatory 1 year of kindergarten, 6 years of elementary, and 4 years of junior high school, and 2 years of senior high school. The K-12 program applies to both public educational institutions and private educational institutions. The two additional years of senior high school will provide graduates with four exits and life options, namely employment, entrepreneurship, higher education, and middle level skills development. What is the legal basis of the K-12 curriculum? The philosophical and the legal basis of the K-12 curriculum are the following. The 1987 Philippine Constitution, BP 232, Education Act of 1982, the four pillars of education, the vision mission statement of the Department of Education, the EDCOM report of 1991, Basic Education Sector Reform Agenda or BESRA, Republic Act number 9155, Philippine Governance Act. The recent news that the K-12 programs were abolished by the government was not true. The K-12 program was created by law, and only a law will abolish or repeal it. It cannot abolish or repeal by the president or anybody for that matter. Remember that the duty or mandate of the President of the Philippines is to enforce the law. Only the Congress of the Philippines, consisting of the Senate and the House of Representatives, has the power to abolish or repeal a law, such as the Enhanced Basic Education Act of 2013, popularly known as K-12. K-12 is an education system under the Department of Education that aims to enhance learners' basic skills, produce more competent citizens, and prepare graduates for lifelong learning and employment. K stands for kindergarten, and 12 refers to the succeeding 12 years of the basic education, 6 years of elementary education, 4 years of junior high school, and 2 years of senior high school. At present, the Philippines is the last country in Asia and one of only 3 countries in the world with a 10-year pre-university program. Why push for K-12 basic education program? The K-12 education system. The K-12 program offers a decongested 12-year program that gives students sufficient time to master skills and absorb basic competencies. Students of the new system will graduate at the age of 18 and will be ready for employment, entrepreneurship, middle-level skills development, and higher education upon graduation. The K-12 program accelerates mutual recognition of Filipino graduates and professionals in other countries. Kindergarten is mandatory of 5-year-old children, a prerequisite for admission to grade 1. The new curriculum gives students the enhanced to choose among 3 tracks. Example, academic, technical vocational livelihood, and sports and arts, and undergo immersion, which provides relevant exposure and actual experience in their chosen track. The old system. Students lack mastery of basic competencies due to a congested 10-year basic education curriculum. graduates of the old curriculum are younger than 18 years old and are not legally ready to get a job or start a business. Foreign countries perceive a 10-year curriculum as insufficient, and they do not automatically recognize overseas Filipino workers or OFWs as professional abroad. Kindergarten, a strong foundation for lifelong learning and total development, is optional and not prerequisite for admission to grade 1. Old education system offers a broad curriculum that does not include enough practical applications. A checklist for evaluating program philosophy statements. An effective philosophy statement has the following characteristics. A. Accuracy. The philosophy represents claims that are supportable. Next, the philosophy states an educationally appropriate case for the role of the specific discipline in the K-12 curriculum and its importance in the education for all students. B. Linkages. The program philosophy is consistent with the district's philosophy of education. The philosophy provides a sound foundation for program goals and objectives. Next, the district's teachers are sincerely committed to each belief outlined in the philosophy. C. Breadth and depth. The philosophy is aligned with sound pedagogical practices. The philosophy provides a clear and compelling justification for the program. D. Usefulness. The philosophy is written in language that is clear and can be understood by parents and other non-educators. The very goal of the K-12 program is to produce 21st century graduates equipped by the core values and lifelong competencies they need to contribute to societal development and nation building. It is designed to provide sufficient time for mastery of concepts and skills, develop lifelong learners, and prepare graduates for tertiary education, middle level skills development, employment, and entrepreneurship. That ends my report about the Articulating a K-12 Program Philosophy. Hoping you've learned something from it. Thank you and God bless us all. Bye!
Trading my sorrows joy of the